One minute we're in a bull market, the next minute we're in a bear market. Market officially down 20%. Bear market time. And tonight, while I'm filming this, or while you're watching this, Trump is probably talking. Which, if he plays his cards right, I didn't get to sit down and talk to him. If he plays his cards right on this one, he could really have the Democrats stuck in a predicament. So I think in the next 30 days, you will see a lot of things a-coming. Now, I'm not a political guy. I don't care. Like I've said before on this channel, it's not about politics. I don't care who you're rooting for. I'm just the guy, like if you play football, I'm just the guy selling the hot dogs at the hot dog stand. The Dow today dropped 1,400 points. So that's it. Bull market, we are officially over. Not to say that tomorrow might be a whole different ballgame. And who officially declared today, well, who did, that we are in a pandemic? Kind of like what I told you guys about in January. People are like, no, it's not a pandemic. And I'm like, okay. And then how I said, we look like we're moving into bear market here. No more bull. No, that's not going to happen. Well, look, this is how you trade the market. Oh no, we just buy and hope. And the Fed gave $175 billion to the banks. Today, yesterday, the day before, tomorrow. Oh man, talk about just money printing like you have never seen before. I always like to put that into perspective. $175 billion, you're like, what is that? Okay, $8 billion to build a wall. That's what Trump groveled to get. It took him like, I don't even know if he still got it. But yet the Fed can go, oh, here you go, bank. Here's $175 billion because of liquidity. I did a video about that a few videos back. I'm doing one a day now, so I get kind of lost in my videos. But I said, that's what will lock the system up. When you try to use this thing right here, you bust out your handy-dandy credit cards, you know, your wallet. You take this thing out. Now, this stuff will work right here. This right here, this works. Currency, that'll always work. Even though it goes down in value, always goes this way. 100%, always currency, it's just sheets of paper. This, kids, this is not money. This is money. Money, not money. This is called currency. This is debt. This is created from a bond, an IOU. This is money, okay? It's been around for ages. And I never really even care about watching the news, never. Never watch the news, but I wanna know what he has to say. It's like a chess move. You know, politics is chess. Marriage is chess. Having six daughters is chess. They're, Dad, do you have some money? I'm like, no money here. Well, what was all that stuff you were just flashing? But like always, this channel isn't about problems, it's about solutions. So I'm going to show you how, again, step by step, how I trade this market, whether it goes this way or it goes that way. I know a lot of people just talk, but at the end, it's just like problems, right? And I have had a lot of people reach out to me in the comment section. They're like, Bill, what are all those lines? So I'll just make an easy trade for you, and then you can kind of set it up and you can go back and go, holy moly, this actually works. Because again, solutions, not problems. Like I threw my wife under the bus the other day. I was saying how, I don't know what it is. I come home and it's like problem. I mean, she's a gorgeous woman, ladies and gentlemen. I love my wife to death, but always problems. And one of my friends was like, hey, are you aware your husband throws you under the bus? And she saw it. I'm like, how dare you? Snitches get stitches and end up in ditches. I'm from Los Angeles, so that's kind of our bumper sticker. Also, Seattle area is canceling schools, and I'm a teacher, so I'm like, well, I guess I'm next, but I guess that'll give me a lot more time to finish my course. And it's a sad day when the Dow Jones Industrial Average ends. It's in the grave. 11-year bull run ends. Today was it. That was it. And also, I've been flashing this stuff. I want to talk to you about those people that flash that stuff, and they sell fear, and then they say, buy my gold, or, you know, buy my silver, or whatever they're selling. I don't want you to get caught with that. This channel did a lot on uncovering those kind of people, and I'll tell you, they come after you with horns. They'll sue you. They start with a cease and desist, and then they'll sue you for defamation. It's beautiful. So I have to be careful that I don't use certain names. Usually, because I own businesses like day spas and hair salons and all the, like, go figure, right? You're like, obviously, Bill, I'm shocked. I never saw you as a day spa owner with that thing that's on top of your head. Yes, I've always been a business owner. I sell things on Amazon, like invisible water bottles. I'll even show you how to do that in this video a little bit at the end if you stay to the end, and guess what? We're starting right now. Welcome back to my not my channel. This is your channel, and my name is, it doesn't matter, because this channel is about you helping you make more money by starting businesses and then taking that said money that you make from the business, and then you decide to, hey, put it in a savings account that's soon going to gain you absolutely zero. Or what's the yield at? 0.5? Nothing? Okay. I mean, like, what do we do with that said money? We invest it. So I'm going to teach you how to invest it. So at least consider, just consider subscribing, like just clicking that little thing that pops up on the screen over here, over there. I don't know. It's going to pop up somewhere. Just click it for me. I would really appreciate it. So here we are. The big news of the day. The Dow drops 1,400 points and tumbles into a bear market. Just like I kind of predicted based on charts, down 20% from record close. Thank you, CNBC. Make sure you don't watch that. Your eyes will fall out. You lose brain cells. And I actually do. I get a lot of heat from people because I tell people it's not about news that drives this stuff. It's not, oh no, it's not the virus, okay? The virus is a catalyst. And I like to explain it like this. You have a wave that's coming. I'm sorry where I paused it. I haven't even heard what they said of why the market is tumbling, but you gotta, you know, for simple people, they need to have the, it's this, it's the trade wars, it's that. But if you think about this, a wave is coming, okay? Now that wave's coming whether you like it or not. And I look at the charts, so I see the charts and I'm like, whoo boy, a wave is a coming. Yes, you have catalysts, like a gigantic boulder that's, you know, thrown into the ocean. It will create a splash. But that catalyst is still coming. The markets are still way overvalued. All of the charts, all of the technicals. And I can show you ahead of time. I'm like, look, 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 it's going to happen. Then, but boom, you know, it happens. And someone has to say, well, it's because China, it's all, they're all better now. You know, we can all go home. But what I will do, just for a moment, I can't believe I'm going to do this. For 15 seconds, let's just see the wisdom that comes from CNBC. And I want to preface you, I've not heard any of this yet.
There is, but we're getting optimistic that we're getting closer to those bottoming levels.
I don't know where the bottom is here. I think we're close to it though.
But they're telling you we're at the bottom. What? What are you even saying? How would you even know we're at the bottom? Have you looked at the support levels? And I'm sorry, I've not gone to the charts all day. I just have to take a quick little peek at the S&P 500 and see if what she's telling us is correct. And lo and behold, oh my gosh, this is pathetically easy. I just opened it up. I can tell you where this market was going to exactly fall to. Can you possibly see a key support or resistance level? Just maybe. Here, I'll get out my handy dandy pen and try to draw it for you. You see this line right here? See this? See the support level? Do, 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 do. Okay. Yeah, that's what we did. We went here, bounced, bounced. Third one usually is the charm. And then it's like, bye-bye. Another one, bounce, another one off of that. And then we're like, okay, yeah, bull market, great. Okay, and then here we go. Where do you think we're gonna bounce? I'll tell you a couple of the places. One of them is gonna be right there, which we did, and it didn't really find too much support there. There's your next support level. Until she's wrong again, and I don't wanna draw some more in there, but we could go down to this level. I could pull the chart back. We can go down to that level. So I'm sorry, Princess Cruises. You may have got this one wrong. You do not know if this is the bottom yet. Sorry, doesn't this kind of look like a cruise ship? Quite possibly. Hold on, let me, right? Do I know what I'm drawing or what? Let me put some windows in here. Okay, there it is, Princess Cruises. You got it wrong. You could do this all day long. See the waves? That's not a MACD. We don't look at that stuff in the RSA. Nah, that's just waves along the cruise ship bear market. And if for some reason I've made you laugh one time, even just a smile, something that is like, you know, took you away from the news. Billy's gonna make it fun, happy, it's okay, you're okay, we're okay. YouTube likes that, the algorithm-like thing. So can you just push that? But if I haven't made you laugh, just dislike. And here's what we talked about before. The good old economy. Fed boosts money it's providing to the banks. Overnight repo. Woo! Banks, you'll promise to pay it back? Oh, yes. Yes, Your Honor, because when they don't, I'm sure they'll all just go to jail, right? 2008, 2009, slaughterhouse of all those all those bankers going to jail. But here you go, 3 hours ago, right here, 3 hours ago, $175 billion, but it's going to stop, we promise. Remember that one time when that politician said, I promise this will be the last time. Was it September that they said this with the repo? And first they called it a glitch. The market kind of was like, whoa, wait, what's going on? Billions and billions of dollars? Who's going to stop them? Fred, you going to stop them? Nope. They just keep going, man. No, we promise. This is just a real quick. Let's see how the story progresses. And once you start government, they just don't stop. The Federal Reserve increased the amount it will make available for overnight bank repo operations from at least $150 billion to $175 billion. You guys really need $175 billion? Just go ahead. Just take it all. Just take it all. And here's one to kick you in the coin purse. Okay, in addition, the central bank extended. Oh, okay, it's 2 week operation. Oh, okay. That was September of last year. September, October, November, December, January, February, March. Okay, we're done in April. We promise. It's gonna end. It's gonna end Thursday. The Fed also added 3 1-month term operations at 50. We'll start on Thursday. Guys, when government starts, they don't stop. This is probably a Federal Reserve building right there. You gotta hang that America, that American flag. And I'm really kind of scared to even look at this 49-second video because this is what it's all about, right? You know what? Ooh, there's a virus, so we need to definitely start pumping billions upon billions into the market. Why? So I can buy hand sanitizer? I was like, do I dare click on it?
Some market demand. The Fed is actually increasing the amount of repo operations it's going to be conducting. It's taking those overnight repo operation, that top limit, from $150 billion to $175 billion. It's keeping in the two-day repo limit of $45 billion, and it's adding a one-month term repo operation that's going to be up to at least $50 billion for those operations. So this is pretty important development, something the market's been looking for. The Fed had made this kind of announcement earlier in the week, taking the overnight repos from 125 to 100.
Yeah, I can see that the market's been looking. They've been really looking for it. It looks great. It's doing great, market. Thanks, Fed. Lower, you know, slashing rates by a half a point. Might as well just take it to zero. But if I had my crystal ball, I'm guessing, Donald, are you going to take it down 75? You're going to leave us with a quarter or a half. Is that about it? Is that what we're looking at? And then that will fix the virus. And oh my gosh, if you have a minute, whenever I say the virus, you guys need to go on YouTube. Like after you watch this stuff, type in, "Mom, I got the virus." You will die laughing. So the mom walks in on this boy and he's like, "Mom! Mom, get out of my room. My pants fell down and I had a virus and I was just pulling my pants up.
I was searching around the internet."
Oh my gosh. Okay, listen.
No, I was searching around the... Mom, I was searching around the internet and all of a sudden I was downloading this thing and I got a computer virus.
I want to see it. Show me what you were downloading.
I deleted the virus. Oh my God, Mom, I had a computer virus and I got scared that I had the virus. And when I was getting out of my chair, my pants were slipping and I was pulling them up and getting back on the chair. I got scared and my pants slipped down a little and I was pulling them up. Mom, I'm telling the truth. I am serious.
Now back to my chess move that Donald can play on the Democrats. And he's a smart guy. You're like, "No, he's a fool. I hate you. Unsubscribe." No, guys, come on. Just let's play nice here, right? Even with my crypto friends and people that like, just to let you know, if you don't know this, people that like gold and silver, they're like, "Ooh, I hate digital currency." You know, it's like this bad fight. I don't ever want to do that. I don't care. All right. So just set that aside. But I do like that he could easily back the Democrats and go, "Okay, this is what I want, okay? And I want, let's bring rates to zero. Let's, because that squashes you. I mean, no longer will you ever save any money. You will spend all of your money, but that's for a whole nother time." Got the new tax plan thingy. that I talked about yesterday in yesterday's video, like mass taxation until what, December? And then we could be like the Fed where it's like, oh, well, let's just go ahead and continue this no tax thing. We need like a no income tax repo market, right? That's what I want. A no income tax repo. I'll be like first one in line. Yeah? No? No income tax? Okay. I'm not saying don't pay your taxes. Always pay your taxes, kids, right? Because they need it. And did you happen to know that in 1912, there was no income tax? And there was no IRS. Can you believe that? I think it was within 6 months of each other. Because you need a task force. You need a police force. If you're not going to pay your taxes, we're going to throw you in jail. Because I'm sure that's pretty constitutional, right? Oh, Bill, come on, man. Your tinfoil hat's a slip in there. Calm down. Take a deep breath and pay your fair share of 55%. And I got one more. I got another thing for you. Just when you thought your job sucked. Talk about shame, man. Like you're a mobile hand sanitizer. This is probably what they need to have at my school. Because I told you that the kids, oh gosh, this just looks terrible. At least it's, you know, chest height, right? They didn't put the hand sanitizer down where it says office services. Although this might be a good Halloween costume. I'm just thinking, maybe? But teaching at the high schools, the kids will kick the soap dispensers off of the wall. Kids, hey kids, we're trying to save your life. We're trying to protect you. And they're like, you're not saving our lives. You die before we do. Kids don't even get affected by this virus. I'm like, great. Well, I would like to wash my hands. And the hand sanitizer, you know what they do with that? They shove it in their backpack and sell it on eBay. And that's probably coming from my business class. You kids are thinking. But here's the story that I told you about. Dow Jones Industrial Average, 11-year bull run ends. This is the longest ever bull market in US history. So today, a bull died. And as I am watching this, it's in front of my hair. I gotta click on this. Hold on just a second. I'm kind of interested in it because we have pollution. Wait, just a second. We can see how China's doing.
This is China covered in pollution last year. But this year, the skies are clear. That's because the virus epidemic had brought much of the country to a standstill for several weeks, causing a huge drop in pollutants like nitrogen dioxide. Shandong and Hebei usually look like after the holiday. They're known for churning out everything from textiles and metals to petrochemicals.
Imagine if your sky looked like that. Geez, to think that you almost need a pandemic just so you can start breathing again. I sell a lot on Amazon, and my friends sell a lot on Amazon. A lot of my friends have had things stuck. It's like, dang it, get this sucker moving. And I always look at the heat maps to see like pollution. And I just did like a couple days ago, and it's starting to pollute a little bit. China will tell you, oh yeah, we're fully 100%. We're like, yeah, you went in and just turned on all the office lights. We can see you're not making squat. But here was a story that I wanted to share with you, you know, that the World Health Organization declared it a pandemic today. So that means that your governments get to spend, even go into more debt. Go figure. More debt for your kids. So that way your life is better and theirs is far worse. Last but not least, I did tell you that, I have two things actually. One, how do I trade this? And two, how to protect yourself from people selling. Just guys, go to eBay and buy it. But Bill, you don't even know if it's authentic. Go to your coin dealer and buy your gold, your silver. You know, you don't need to go to, won't even say his name. I have a lot of respect for the guy. But you know, when you call Wolf over and over and over again, yes, I know we're going to be in a depression in 2007, in 2008, in 2009. It's like you kind of give up after about 10 years. Yeah, you had your window to call things. But be really careful, people. And this is across the board with whoever. You gotta follow the money. That's what I'm going to teach you. At the end of the day, when it's all said and done, follow the money trail. So 2000 gold coming, brace for the greatest depression. I would say, put that word in Google and then put that word in Google and see how far back you can go with greatest depression and people's names. Like this stuff right here. I don't know if it's going to be green or what. Sometimes I hold things up, right? Like my water bottle, my invisible water bottle. So hopefully these guys make a ton of money and there's no competition. And what does this take? Like it's plastic and I use it in my in my house. You're like, are you using, it's called Regal Flame Fireplace Fuel. So I have a portable fireplace in my living room. You're like, on the table, and you fill it up and you light it, and friends come over and they're like, wow, that's magical. So it's kind of cool, but I bought the fireplace not thinking about, oh, what about this stuff? And then this stuff makes so much money. These guys are making putting this in a plastic bottle, and there's relatively no competition. So me as an Amazon seller, and link in the description if you want the course on how to do that, it's like 80 videos and I only leave one code, so only one person gets it. So grab it. It's probably already grabbed. Sorry. This is cool, man. You start your own business so you don't get all yucky about what's happening in the markets, because you have your own business and money's coming in. And yeah, maybe a little less, you know, over the next 6 months, but you got this because you're a business owner. And I said, if you waited to the end of the video, which we're here, I'm going to actually show you how I'm going to trade something, which I told a lot of people. They're like, show us how you trade this. So the good news is I just filmed this. This is my second time. I went way too long. I need to speed it up, so I'm going to do that. I am on the 4 hour on Bitcoin. This is the chart, TradingView, link in the description. Now here is how I quickly will trade. Number one, here is the SMA line right there. It's a 20, a 50, 200. I get rid of the 200, I get rid of the 50. We're just looking at the 20. I'm looking at the 20. It needs to go underneath the 20. It comes above the 20, and then one wick, one candle above the 20, that's where we put in a buy. So this, it goes underneath, okay, perfect. Comes up, this is where we buy, right there. Can we see that on the screen? This is where I'm gonna buy. Again, not financial advice. When it drops, you know, and it can hug this line, bounce, 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 bounce. But when the candle body goes underneath the line, like you see right here, this is where I'm going to close my position on Bitcoin. And if we were to do the percentage on that, that would be a, what are we looking at? That's about a 5.5%, 5-6% gain on that. Same situation right here. I'm going to try to do it quickly. We drop underneath. Oops, I'm using the wrong one. Let me use this one. So same thing. Drops underneath the SMA, it comes above, you buy, whatever. Some people are like, if we're above it, but a lot of times some people like to get a complete close, new candle. But you're buying here, and then when it drops below, you are selling. Or when the candle, not the wick, but the candle drops below, you're selling. So as you guys can see, that candle was below. So on this one, you could have essentially, let me do the percentage on this one. And it's not an always. I just randomly open this up and let's see what we're going to get on this one. Let's say it comes above. We buy. And where did it close? It closed right there. You know, we were looking at 1% gain on that one. Same thing. It comes up. It's up. We close because it goes underneath. That would be like a break even. Now it's easier to trade definitely in a bull market than it is a bear market. And this is Bitcoin resembling a bear market. I don't know. I got out at 8,300. I have not been trading it since those levels. And if I have given you value, again, you made it to the very end, consider subscribing, and I will catch you in the next video.